YouTube, how's it going? The Goat House is back, and I feel a Westbrook trade coming. At first, I thought it was just all talk, you know, but now I actually feel it coming, so I thought, why not? Let's make a trade scenarios video. We did pretty well in our pre-draft trade scenarios. So I got four different Russell Westbrook trades here, four different teams. The last one I'll show is the one I think is most likely. So right before we get started with these scenarios, 40K is our subscriber goal by the end of this year. It'd be much appreciated if you can subscribe to our channel. And I think it's worth it for you because we have daily sports videos, NFL, NBA, constant content here at the Goat House. Twitter is in the top right, also link in the description. Clicking that like button would be much, much appreciated. Let's go to this first trade. And I've actually seen a lot of trade scenarios. I think people are, you know, a little delusional with what they would have to give up. Maybe I'm wrong. I don't know. But I think people are thinking their teams won't have to give up a whole bunch. But I still think he's a top-tier player. You know, he hasn't been able to win much, but I'm still a fan of his game. So the first trade here is with the Rockets, and it's quite a load there going to OKC. As you can see, four first-round picks, and we've seen how many picks, along with young talent and Gallinari, go to OKC for Paul George. So I think it can take something similar in amount of picks. So Russell Westbrook going to the Rockets. OKC gets Clint Capella, who's definitely a solid big man. Wasn't as good this year as he was the year before, mainly in the playoffs. I think people expected a little more, but still some upside there. Eric Gordon still can play, still can put up some points, but you know, not what he once was. Difference in a year or two. And then four first-round picks, which is a lot, but kind of breaking it down here, you know, maybe you expected Chris Paul to be involved in this, but I just don't see anybody. We already heard that it doesn't sound like anyone wants to take Chris Paul because there's 4 years left on that contract with $38.5 million. So you're pretty much stuck with that. And the Thunder aren't trying to stay, you know, obviously they're going to get worse trading Russell Westbrook. But they're not trying to stay, like, kind of average. And that's what they would be doing getting Chris Paul if they really wanted him. You know, they're trying to just go in rebuild mode. And Clint Capella can work because he's young. Four-year deal, you know, about $15 million in salary. So, you know, not Chris Paul pricey, but pretty pricey. But can be part of that rebuild. Eric Gordon, you know, he's not really part of the rebuild, but he only has 1 year left. A lot of money in that 1 year and just over $14 million, but only 1 year left. So OKC basically has to take that in so the Rockets can afford Russell Westbrook. And they don't have a problem taking it in because he won't be a cap hit in that rebuild because it's only a 1 year deal, you know, pretty much tank this year. And they may be able to win some games because they do have some pieces there, but. So I think Chris Paul won't be involved. And the reason there'll be four first-round picks is because, I mean, even though maybe they don't want Eric Gordon, but it's not that big of a deal because it's only 1 year, they still really don't want him. You know, they pretty much have to take him in because the Rockets cap situation. And Capella, they did pay him quite a bit of money. You know, he's going to get 14.8, just about $15 million. So for maybe a little bit overpaid, we still really don't know. So it's not like they have to have Capella, you know. It's just they really want the draft picks so they can, because they have a load of draft picks, so they potentially can move up and down or trade for some other pieces when they become available. So, and the Rockets are pretty desperate. So that going on top of that, which leads me to four first round picks. They're pretty desperate. They haven't really done anything in free agency. And James Harden was very frustrated with not only Chris Paul, with the rest of the team, how they're playing, and with the front office, because he didn't have the right pieces around him. He made that very, very clear, and they still don't have the pieces. Obviously, they tried to get the pieces. They couldn't do it. I think Jimmy Butler was in their plan. So they're pretty desperate at this point not to stay the same as last year and get the chemistry back up. So they're going to have to try to make a move like this. I don't know if it happens. I think there's a chance. That's why I have it up here. But I think this would have to what the deal would have to be. So that's what I got with the Rockets deal. We're moving on to another team here, and that's the Pistons. Kind of linked to the Pistons. People seem to think it makes sense. So three first-round picks involved in this one, and also Reggie Jackson, Luke Kennard, and Langston Galloway for Russell Westbrook going to the Pistons. So you may say, why three first-round picks, not four, which the Rockets had to give up, and maybe the best player out of both of those deals is Clint Capella. So you may be confused. Well, I just don't know if there's as much money here. And I actually think Reggie Jackson could be appealing because he was pretty darn good on the Thunder. They liked him a lot. They didn't really want to see him go, but he wanted that starting role. So he can make his way back. He's getting paid a lot of money for this year, $18 million, but it's only 1 year. So it's kind of a, you know, tryout, I guess, this year. But he could be appealing because they could like Reggie Jackson to come back. Langston Galloway's only a one-year deal. So not a part of the future. And they don't have to worry about that after this year. And Luke Kennard is a guy that hasn't really worked out, but still has some upside. 2 year, $3.8 million in salary. So not a whole bunch of money there with the guy that can possibly shoot and possibly has some upside. And then they still get some first round picks because really the future guaranteed here is probably Luke Kennard because the other two only have 1 year deals. But again, like I said, Reggie Jackson could be somewhat appealing, but then the first rounders coming with it, pretty good too, because you know, the Pistons, if they did get Westbrook with Blake Griffin, they got Derrick Rose over there too. You know, not the best pick. It's going to be later, but maybe not as late as the Rockets. So maybe not as many first round picks. So I think this is, and I've seen trade scenarios, pretty much a similar trade. I think I've seen one that was Reggie Jackson, Luke Kennard, and Tony Snell without any picks. And that just blew my mind. They'd have to give up picks. You know, people just think because Westbrook's contract is huge means they want to dump him. No way. Everybody's contract's huge in the NBA. He's maybe the best athlete in basketball. Maybe not the best player, but he's definitely up there. I think he's a top-tier player. I think he's an elite player. You don't see guys like this every day. You're going to have to give up picks. So maybe because of the cap situation, this one's a little more likely than the Rockets, but the Rockets will be desperate. I don't know if the Pistons are desperate because they have to sit here and realize, will they win something with Westbrook? You know, adding him with Blake Griffin, Andre Drummond, even though I wasn't thrilled with his game last year, and then Derrick Rose they added, can that win something? You know, I don't know if it will. I'm a big Blake Griffin fan as well as Westbrook in their game. But I don't know if it'll win. Maybe they believe so. So they really have to think about this. Next deal is with the T-Wolves. I don't know. Maybe the T-Wolves is the least likely because they have to kind of recognize if they will win or not with him too. I don't know if they can do it. You know, maybe they can compete, contend. I don't know if they'll do it. They're pretty desperate too, I guess, because they really wanted D'Angelo Russell, couldn't quite get him. And they're almost desperate to trade Andrew Wiggins at this point. So as you can see, Andrew Wiggins, Jeff Teague, Josh Okogie, and two first-round picks. So another step down in the amount of picks. Why? Because, I guess everyone's split on this, but Andrew Wiggins, to me, still, I think he can still play. You know, and I think he has maybe a little upside, too. I think people rip him a little too much. Maybe he just doesn't work out with the T-Wolves. I think he has, you know, he's nothing special, but I think he has, I think he can play. He's got a game, I think. Jeff Teague, that's kind of just the cap that the T-Wolves have to give up there. Obviously, he can still play a solid point guard, but nothing crazy. And the good thing is he's a one-year deal. And then Josh Okogie actually has some value to him. Just a rookie last year, a guy that can play point or shooting guard. And pretty good defense. I was pretty impressed with his defense. So that kind of brings some value. Maybe he's the point guard or shooting guard of the future there with Gilgeous Alexander. Jeff Teague is just to take in some cap for the T-Wolves to kind of help them out. 1 year, $19 million. That's a lot of money, but it's only 1 year, so not a part of the future, kind of just like they want. Wiggins, Okogie could be part of the future along with the two first-round picks, so won't need as many picks. And the T-Wolves, it could still, you know, be a pick that's not that bad of a pick. You know, it could be mid to late, but not as late as, you know, the Rockets pick. So still getting two unprotected. All these picks, by the way, would be unprotected in my eyes. All the picks that I have involved in any of these trade scenarios. So Westbrook with Karl Anthony Towns, Jarrett Culver, who I like. I don't see that team winning, you know. Maybe a similar situation what Westbrook had with the Thunder. Maybe a little better as of recently. But I don't know if they win anything. So the T-Wolves got to be careful there. But that's really the main reason why it's only two first-round picks, but it's kind of a lot because it's unprotected, could be decent picks, and you get value out of Wiggins and Okogie. So the trade I think is most likely to happen out of any of these, and I guess the landing spot, I should say, is the Miami Heat. He's kind of been linked there. Sounds like he almost wants to play there now. The struggle for this to happen is, and there's, I'll mention at the end, there's two other teams that maybe I could have put in here, a couple other teams we'll talk about, but yeah, the problem, why this is a holdup, why there's a holdup here, the Heat don't really want to give up who they just drafted, Tyler Hero, but I think they're considering it, and they like Bam a lot too. You know, he's a solid big man, young big man they like for the future, so they may have to give him up in the situation. But the main thing holding it back is Tyler Hero. Also going along is Goran Dragic, who can still play, but not really part of OKC's future maybe rebuild plans, but they kind of have to take in the cap for the Heat, kind of helping them out. And then two first-round picks. Why two? Like the T-Wolves? Because you get some young talent here with Hero and Adebayo. So, and then, I mean, Dragic can play too, but it's only a one-year deal. So looking at the contracts of from these guys, I mean, Hero's yet to be, you know, 100% signed. So this could be a reason, or it could just mean nothing. But Dragic's only got 1 year left. So, I mean, they could be out of that if they want to, just like that. And then Bam's got the three-year, $3.5 million. So not a whole bunch of money dished out there for a solid young talent. I think this is most likely because it just sounds like the top landing spot where he wants to go, and it sounds like OKC's down for it if Tyler Hero's involved. I'm not super high on Tyler Hero, so I would like this deal for the Heat. I've seen scenarios where they don't get the two first-round picks with this. Maybe it's one, maybe it's none. I think that's nonsense. I think that would be an absolute steal by the Miami Heat. Even the way it sits like this, because I don't know if Tyler Hero's going to be a solid, you know, he's athletic, he can shoot. I don't know if he's going to be a starter. I think he'll be a solid rotation guy. That's how I view him. Maybe a little better than that, but nothing crazy. So I think this would be a really good deal for the Heat. Just like the other teams, what the Heat got to recognize here is, can they win? You know, it's not the biggest window, not a tiny window, but can they win with Westbrook and Jimmy Butler? And, you know, Winslow is part of this deal. I don't think they want to give him up, but they also had plans to play him at point guard because he was doing pretty well at the end of the year there. So maybe they won't really see a need for him if Westbrook's in there. So who knows? But can they win with Westbrook and Jimmy Butler? It's pretty much those two guys, so maybe they can't. So even though I think it's a good deal, maybe step off a little bit, get some more good picks next year, don't give up the picks. So kind of back and forth on it, but it sounds like the Heat are the most likely landing spot at this point. Some other teams I considered, some teams I've seen rumored. Apparently the Thunder actually called the Raptors about a possible deal. I don't think the Raptors are in on that, but that's been rumored, so that's why I did not include them. And the Knicks have been rumored, but the Knicks just make no sense whatsoever. That's just a pure rebuild team. You don't go get a guy like this, even though I think he's very good, it makes the team better. You don't go do this if you're a rebuild. You're not going to win anything with him and RJ Barrett. Get some other pieces. Julius Randle's solid, but you're not going to win anything. There's no point to it. No point to giving up picks. You're still not better than the teams he had with the Thunder, so you're not going to win anything. And your picks you're giving up may be decent picks, so no reason for the Knicks to do it. I've seen people talk about the Bulls possibly doing it. I just don't see it. Pretty wild for him in Chicago, but I just don't see it. They would have to give up LaVine probably, then they want to hang on to him. They have to give up LaVine and more, so that's the tricky part. But are they going to win anything with LaVine? Probably not. With Westbrook, I guess that takes him a step up for now, but are they going to win anything in the near future? They got a pretty solid, I guess, team going for the future, but I guess keep it that way is my point. But pretty cool. It would be a pretty cool team with Westbrook on the Bulls, I guess. But don't think that happens. I think these four teams are the most likely, but I'd say the Heat, like I said. So let me know your guys' thoughts, any other teams or scenarios you think are possible. That's going to do it for this one. We have plenty of NFL and NBA videos already on the channel, plenty more to come. Full NFL coverage for the upcoming season. Cannot wait for that. College football coverage as well, predictions, previews, and then weekly picks for that coming up too. Click that subscribe button. It'll be worth it, and we would appreciate it very much. But that's going to do it for this one. Thanks, everyone, for watching. Goodbye.